The air is cool, the snow is falling, people are singing, and presents lay beneath the tree. Could it be? Yes, it is that time of year again. My favorite time of year, Christmas time. What is more wonderful than Christmas? It's a time for celebration, a time for laughter, and a time the whole world comes together to celebrate our differences. It's a time to get cozy with a nice cup of cocoa and a plate full of delicious cookies, to be close to family, friends, and strangers alike. No doubt, there is a certain magic in the air when Christmas comes to town that has a way of just putting the biggest smiles on people's faces. But you know what I love most about Christmas? It's the time of year when Santa comes down the chimney and brings all sorts of wonderful presents just for me. Oh, I cannot wait. I wonder what I am getting this year. New toys? New video games? Or a box set of Paw Patrol? Who can say? I shall find out soon, for tomorrow is Christmas. Oh, I cannot wait. I love this holiday so much. I love it so that I think I may just sing about it.
Haul out the holly, put up the tree before my spirit falls again. Fill up the stocking, I may be rushing things, but deck the halls again now. For we need a little Christmas right this very minute. Candles in the window, carols up the spinet. Yes, we need a little Christmas right this very minute. Hasn't snowed a single furry, but Santa dear, we're in a hurry. Climb down the chimney, turn on the brightest string of lights I've ever seen. Slice up the fruitcake, this time we hung some tinsel on the evergreen bough. For I've grown a little leaner, grown a little colder, grown a little sadder, grown a little older. Sitting on my shoulder, need a little Christmas now. Singing, ringing through the rafter, and we need a little snappy, happier after. Need a little Christmas. No!
Dave, come on, Dave, time to get up. Dave, wake up!
5 more hours, Catherine.
No, dear, it's an important day we need to get ready for.
Oh boy, it's Christmas, yay. It's Christmas, what did Santa get me? Yeah.
It happened again.
How many times is that now?
Dunno, how many days into December are we?
Oh boy, what presents did I get? What? Oh no. Santa didn't get me anything, but why have I been a bad boy this year? Yes, that must be it. Oh. Oh, woe is me. Why?
Dave,
stop it.
Dave, stop it. Would you get off the floor?
But Catherine.
Brian, Emma, that's enough.
Santa didn't bring me anything. Why didn't you tell me how bad of a boy I have been all year? Why?
Dave, you don't understand. It's not Christmas.
It isn't.
Yes, so you are throwing a big tantrum for nothing.
But, I was sure it was today.
Nope, Christmas is a week from today.
Oh.
Making mountains out of anthills again, dear.
Then why did you say it was an important day?
Because Christmas is next week, and we need to do some last-minute shopping for Christmas dinner. So please, get ready, you three, so we can get going.
According to meteorologists, this Christmas will be the coldest Christmas Vian City has seen in the past 40 years. But despite the hazardous conditions, good old Saint Nick has no intention of altering his usual course. Be sure you and your loved ones stay extra safe this holiday season. And now we have a lineup of your favorite holiday hits, here on the puddle, except for Mariah Carey, Fuck That Song.
Oh boy, Santa is coming in a week, I cannot wait, I wonder what I am getting.
Dad, you know that Santa only brings presents for kids, right?
That is right, Brian. Sorry, Dave, but you aren't getting anything from Santa. You should have known that.
Wait.
That's right, you are a grown man. Santa Claus has to keep his focus on the kids.
Oh no.
Yes, it's a sad truth, dear, but that is part of growing up. All you are left with is special memories, so when you see Brian and Emma opening their Santa gifts, just try and remember what it was like when you were young.
Oh no.
Come on, Dave, don't get upset.
But I forgot to write a letter to Santa.
Dave, were you even listening to me?
You're talking. I didn't notice.
Oh, never mind.
Oh dear, what am I going to ask Santa for this year?
Read the signs, sheeple. Christmas is under attack. We need to save it.
Christmas? Under attack?
Yes, they want to destroy the Lord's holiday. Are you going to let that happen?
Christmas is in danger. Oh no.
Don't let modern day taint you.
Did you just say Christmas is under attack?
Yes, sir. Finally, someone is listening to us.
No, it cannot be. Christmas in danger.
It sure is. There are people out there who want to outlaw Christmas altogether.
No.
I am afraid so. They are trying to pass a bill in Congress right now to round up anyone who celebrates this sacred holiday.
Yeah, those degenerates hate us and hate America. We are such victims.
I don't understand. Why would anyone want to do that? Don't they know Christmas is the most wonderful time of the year?
Right. Christmas is supposed to be a time to celebrate the birth of our Lord, and the people of this country have lost their way.
It all started when they stopped having prayers in schools.
Just look around. They don't let anyone decorate for Christmas anymore. If they catch you trying to celebrate Christmas in a public place, you will receive a life sentence.
No way.
Believe it, my friend, and God bless your soul if you are caught putting up a nativity scene depicting the baby Jesus. They just don't allow that anymore.
Once I heard in the town of Thomasville, Wyoming, an angry mob burnt down a house of a family who dared put up Christmas lights.
That sounds horrible. What can we do about it?
What's your name, big fella?
Oh, my name is Dave. Dave Johnson.
Hello, brother Dave. The name is Ted. Ted Rutledge. This is my wife, Janice.
Hello.
And my son, Jake.
Hi there.
And our friend, Frank Bowman.
Thanks for hearing us out, brother Dave.
Good to see there are still true red-blooded Americans these days.
Here, take a leaflet, educate yourself on the war on Christmas.
Okay, Brian and Emma, what do you want for Christmas dinner?
You know it's got to be prime rib.
With an extra crunchy spice crust.
Sounds good, and what about you, Dave? Dave? Where is your father?
Did he not come in with us?
I dunno, he was right behind you, Mom.
Or Catherine, kids, it's horrible, just horrible.
Dave, what are you babbling about?
Or Catherine, it's bad. Really bad.
Dave, stop it. Just tell us what's wrong.
They want to make it against the law. Frank told me they burn down houses.
Slow down. Who's burning down houses? And who's Frank?
The leaflet, Catherine, the leaflet.
Wait, Frank is the leaflet.
No, leaflet would burn down the house, and the lights would put up Frank. No, I mean, oh no.
Dave, just slow down. Start from the beginning.
There's a war on Christmas, Catherine. They want to make it illegal.
Dad. You know this stuff is nonsense, right?
Yo, Dave, this junk is just a conspiracy theory. Best you not take it seriously.
Yes, it is a conspiracy. A conspiracy to destroy this wonderful holiday.
You know, I am surprised you know what conspiracy means.
Oh, Brian and Emma, don't worry. Papa will not let anything bad happen to you.
You are right, Dave, because nothing is going to happen at all.
I have been called my family. I have been called to a special calling, for this is my favorite holiday, and these evil forces that wish to tear it down and punish those who stand for it shall not prevail. Christmas is in trouble. It needs my help. I, David William Jonathan Johnson, colloquially known as the Childish Dad.
I am surprised you know what colloquial means.
We'll save Christmas.
You know, Dave, at this point I am used to you putting on the scene whenever we go out. But at least you aren't throwing a big baby tantrum.
Hey, look, it's the famous Childish Dad. And this must be your family. You know, I am really surprised that you have had sex.
Look here, sir, you should know better to then talk like that in front of kids.
Mum, you gave me the talk when I was Emma's age.
Yeah, and mine after my birthday this year.
Emma, could you imagine if Dad was the one to give us the talk?
Gee, I wonder what that would be like.
Brian, Emma, don't start. Come on, let's go. By the way, sir, everything my husband is, I am into it. Happy holidays, sir.
To work with your hands? Do you like arts and crafts? Do you love model structures? Then Papa Porgy's Play Palace is for you! With this dynamic DIY toy castle coming in four perfect color variants: periwinkle, parmesan, parsley, and pitch black. And with 20 possible configurations, Papa Porgy's Play Palace is the best gift for you this Christmas! Whether you be a boy, a girl, undecided, or an emotionally immature man-child, you will love Papa Porgy's Play Palace!
Wow. Well, Catherine, it's perfect. It's a toy castle that you can construct yourself, and there are several ways to do it. It's so cool.
No, we already finished present shopping.
Yeah, but this is going to be the gift I asked Santa for.
Oh no.
If he had only listened.
Do as you wish, dear. Just don't be disappointed if it doesn't pan out the way you plan.
Dear Santa, Dave here. Sorry my letter is so late this year, but I finally found what I wanted. I am pleased to present my personal present I picked is Papa Porgy's Plague Palace. In periwinkle, please. I have been a very good boy all year, and I look forward to seeing it under the tree Christmas morning. Love, Dave. There, it's done. Hope I was not too late.
Dad, dinner's ready.
No. How can Santa get me my present when Christmas is going to be destroyed?
Oh my, this time of year is so exhausting. Hell, a new letter for the boss. It's pretty late into December for that, isn't it? Oh no, not this guy again.
Oh, Peter Lee.
Hey, Mingo.
You going to see the boss?
That's right.
Okay, see you later then, Tilly.
You too, Mingo.
Enter. Hello, Tilly.
Hello, SC.
You called?
No, not you. Santa Claus.
Oh, okay.
You here for your report?
I am, but there is something I need to show you first. Here, catch. It's the Childish Dad again. You know, this year I really thought he would have gotten the hint by now, but apparently he did not.
That is indeed unfortunate.
I know he isn't, you know, all there, but if he has to be reminded this many times, is there really any hope for him?
It's always good to have an outlook on Christmas, as if one has the heart of a child, but rules are rules. Santa only delivers presents to kids.
It's hard not to feel for his family. I don't envy them when Mr. Johnson wakes up, only to find nothing for himself under the tree.
All we can do is hope that he eventually gets it through his head one day. Anyway, Tilly, how is the weather looking for Christmas Eve?
Oh, not good, SC. It's looking to be one of the coldest and stormiest winters in a very long time.
Very peculiar.
You don't think, you know, Krampus has anything to do with it?
I cannot say. But as a spirit of the holidays, Krampus thrives off of belief. So if he has regained some of his powers, then someone must be helping him.
If it is Krampus, what should we do?
We should be patient. Christmas is the reason we do what we do. The children of the world are counting on us. Besides, I have the best polar navigator in the world with me.
Thank you, Santa.
Well, Catherine, what am I going to do? How am I going to get Papa Porgy's Play Palace if Christmas is going to be ruined?
You really need to learn how to listen. Those people are crackpots. No one is trying to ruin Christmas.
But how can you be so sure?
The idea of the war on Christmas is nothing new, and there has never been anything to suggest that anyone is seriously trying to destroy the holiday.
But Catherine, I have such a bad feeling about this. What if they are right? Oh, I don't want Christmas to go away.
Dave, that's quite enough. You are getting yourself worked up again. It's been a long day. I think it's time for bed, everyone. Good night, Brian and Emma. Come on, Dave. Look, I know you are worried, but it's easy to get sucked into things like this. You just need to sleep it off. You will feel much better in the morning. Christmas is next week, your favorite time of the year. Just focus on that. Come on, come to bed.
The Knights for Christ, what can I do for you?
This is Dave. We met earlier today. I want to help save Christmas.
Brian. What did you ask Santa for this year?
You're just gonna have to wait and see, sis. How about you?
A new pair of quad skates, of course.
Planning on doing roller derby or something?
No, that's a bit too brutal for me.
Says the girl who dad has been crashing through every December morning.
Someone's here.
Strange, we don't normally get visitors out here.
Who are they? Do you know them?
No, never seen them before.
Good morning, Brother Dave. Thank you for having us.
Please tell me I am not too late to save Christmas.
Of course not. We have until Christmas Eve. We have time.
Guys, it's horrible, just horrible. There is a happy holiday sign hanging in the living room.
Get that filth off your wall this instant.
But my wife will kill me when she gets home.
Don't you know that phrase is one of their weapons? Taking Christmas out of our vocabulary is a sinister plot to erase Christmas. Now, take it down. I now call this meeting of the Knights for Christ to order. First order of business, let us welcome our newest member, Dave Johnson.
Anything to save this holiday? If it is ruined, Santa can't bring me what I want for Christmas.
Santa, that pagan heathen.
Frank, of course, Dave, we are grateful for your contribution to the cause.
Santa is bringing me Papa Porgy's Play Palace in Periwinkle. Have you seen the commercials? It looks so fun.
Sounds great, Dave.
Ted, what are you doing?
Just wait. So Dave, since you are our host, why don't you make us some drinks?
Sure thing, Ted. I have a job now as a preschool bus driver, and I just bought my favorite drink with my own money.
Dad, what is this?
This is going completely against the plan.
This is blasphemy! You cast your lot with a pagan who worships the false prophet, Santa Claus!
Look, we need all the help we can get, and this Dave guy is an idiot. And you all know, idiots are easy to manipulate. Just play along with his nonsense, and he will do whatever we tell him.
Hello?
Hello?
And you people are...
The Knights for Christ.
The Modern Day Warriors for Christmas.
Oh, so you're the War on Christmas people we have heard so much about.
Which one of you is Frank the Leaflet?
Hey, my name is just Frank.
I like Frank the Leaflet better. That's what my dad called you.
How dare you mock me? Someone get that little hussy back into the kitchen where she belongs.
Little hussy?
I thought it may have been you people, given how our secular Christmas decor is sitting in the garbage.
What rude brats you two are. Don't you know children are supposed to be sweet and docile?
Yeah, and I suppose your husband is your master, right?
Kids these days, with no respect for their elders.
How dare you twerps talk to my parents like that? If I ever talked back when I was your age, it would be the belt for me.
Papa, Papa. Please, Papa. Not the rabbit costume. No, 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 no.
Ignore that.
I've got the drinks. Drink up, friends. To saving the best holiday in the world.
Is this apple juice?
Yep, my favorite drink in the whole wide world.
You don't have anything stronger.
But it is stronger. It's organic. Oh, I see you have met my kids. This is Brian and Emma.
Your kids? Oh no, he gets more action than me.
Kids, these are my new best friends.
We've met. They sure are charming.
Great to hear. Me and them are going to be doing a lot of important things together. So happy to see that you all get along so well.
We're basically old friends at this point. Come on, Emma. Let's let all of these clearly well-adjusted grown-ups have their meeting. Don't want our kid Ashura to bother them.
Okay, gang. What's next?
Okay, son. Give our new soldier a rundown of the plan. But don't mention you know who.
Yes, sir. Okay, Brother Dave. The people who want to destroy Christmas are planning their attack on Christmas Eve night. Our contact has provided us with a secret weapon.
Surface-to-air missiles!
Shush.
We will use these secret weapons to stop the perps.
Weapons? But my mama always told me it's not nice to use things that could hurt people.
That is why we have a special job for you, Dave. We need you to keep lookout on the other end of the field to make sure there aren't more of the enemy trying to give us the slip. Can you do that?
A lookout? Yeah, just like a pirate ship.
Sure, you could put it that way. Are you there, Angel?
Yes. Are the preparations complete?
Roger that. The plan is falling into place.
Good. Now remember, I want Santa Claus alive. I want to punish him myself for his transgressions.
We will make him pay for his crimes against Christmas.
Make him regret.
Make him squeal!
Yes, my flock. The heathen Santa Claus will get what is coming to him. And you will all be handsomely rewarded.
Thank you, Angel. But the real reward is serving the Lord and bringing back Christmas the way it used to be.
Yes, the way Christmas used to be.
I will ensure that is what happens. Now go forth, my flock, and deliver unto me what you have sworn. Yes, the way Christmas used to be. Like it was back in the Dark Ages, when I ruled supreme, before those damned, loathsome heretics took over. You had better watch out. And you better cry. Because Krampus is coming to town.
Here comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. Vixen and Blixen and all his reindeers pulling on the reins. Bells are ringing, children singing, all is merry and bright. So hang your stockings and say your prayers, cause Santa Claus comes tonight. Here comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. He's got a bag filled with toys for boys and girls again. Hear the sleigh bells jingle, jingle, oh, what a beautiful sight. So jump in bed and cover your head, cause Santa Claus comes tonight.
Thank you all for another year of your service to this wonderful holiday. As you may have heard, this Christmas Eve night has been accosted by a turbulent winter storm, and it will do us no favor. However, I am Santa Claus, and I refuse to yield at this inconvenience. The children of the world are counting on me, and I will never let them down.
Yes, don't give up, Nicholas. I would hate to miss your final trip.
I have no doubt in my mind that we will make it through tonight, as I will be accompanied by our one and only Tilly, the best navigator in the world. Dash away, dash away, dash away all.
Weather. What is the weather? What does the weather globe say today?
And so it begins. It's all yours, Tilly. My fate is in your hands.
Fret not, Nicholas. Your hardships will all be over soon. You will worry no longer about the Yuletide. As of tonight, Krampus will be taking his rightful place. Come along, Saki. Who's ready to devour some naughty little children? Good little Saki Wacky.
Merry Christmas. You all have a wonderful holiday. God bless. You folks have a wonderful evening and a Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Pasta. Okay, family, who's ready for dessert and our ranking base marathon?
Dave, come on, it's time.
But the ranking base marathon.
Dave, we have to go now.
What is this? What's going on?
It's the war on Christmas, people, Mom.
You have got to be kidding me. Come on, Dave, let's go home.
But if I don't go, Christmas will be...
No! Don't say it. Christmas is not in trouble. You have been sucked into a lie.
Final warning.
But if I don't go, I'll never get Papa Porgy's Play Palace in Periwinkle.
Look, dear, let's just go home and have a fun and relaxing Christmas with the kids. Forget about all this nonsense.
Cheer up, man. We are saving Christmas tonight. When we are all done, your family will understand.
Mom,
is everything okay?
Let's just go.
Fear East, boss.
Okay, team. Tonight is the night. On this day we stop the heathens, and things will return to the way they used to be. From this day forward, Christmas will be celebrated the way God intended, and America will proceed into the future holding on to these traditional values. Battle stations, everyone.
Ha, never seen her like this before.
Yeah, she's totally depressed.
Just goes to show that adults too don't always have it together. Well, there's only one thing we can do.
Oh? And what is that?
Okay, Dave, you wait here and keep an eye down the hill. Make sure no one comes this way.
Aye, Captain. Our captain, methinks me spy something off the poop deck. Aw, poop deck.
Okay, all I got to do is track Dad's phone.
You can do that.
Yep, I have a tracker on everyone's phone, even yours.
Brian.
It's only because I care a little, sis. There he is.
Santa, we should be approaching Beyond City at any moment.
If Angel's instructions are correct, we should be seeing the sleigh coming due east any moment.
Shiver me timbers, me hearties. I am Davy Jones, the most feared pirate on the seven seas. Why?
Okay, Anna, here's the plan. After we track Dad and find him, we're going to convince him to come home and celebrate Christmas.
Almost there, just over the ridge.
We got a signal, just over the ridge.
Dad is nearby, just over the ridge.
Santa. It's him. It's really him.
There you are.
Ready. Steady.
What was that?
We're being shot at.
Shot at? Oh no.
Again.
Another.
We're hit. Boss, we're going down. Boss, oh no, wake up. I can't drive this thing.
Did you hear that?
An aircraft must have crashed in the storm.
We sure showed that pagan bastard.
Oh, Ted, Christmas is saved.
Yes, nice work, team. Wakey, wakey. Climb down, slowly. Santa Claus, your infidel ways have come to an end. Now Christmas can proceed the way God intended.
Put your hands up.
Now, start walking.
No. What are you doing?
Dave, I told you to stay on the hill.
Why did you do that? Let him go.
Back off, Dave. I am warning you.
But this is wrong. You can't do this.
Oh, really? Okay, have it your way.
New friends. Who else? Over here.
Who is she?
Oh my God, she's an elf. She's so cute.
What did you say?
Come on, let's help her.
We'll deal with you later.
We're going to throttle you, lashes for the sinner.
Please don't hurt us.
Should have thought about that before choosing a life of wickedness.
Stay calm, Dave. Be patient.
Rot like the scum you are.
You know my name.
Of course, I am Santa Claus.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay.
That's good. Can you tell us what happened?
Last I remember, we were flying, and then the missus came, and then, oh no. Where is the boss? Where is Santa?
Now. Kids. Brian.
Dear Mom, Emma and I are going to find Dad to convince him to come home and spend Christmas with us. Be back soon. Love, Brian.
This is bad, real bad. Without Santa, there is no Christmas.
Oh, that's not true. I mean, isn't the spirit of Christmas beyond Santa?
No, you don't understand. If Santa isn't there to spread holiday cheer, then something else will.
Who is that?
You two aren't naughty, are you? You know, committing crimes, being rude to others.
Committing crimes, and being rude, clearly deserving of equal punishment.
Stay behind me.
Well, 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 if it isn't one of St. Nick's little imps.
Krampus?
You are not Krampus, I am Krampus. The true specter of you. So displeased to make your acquaintance.
He's funny.
No, he's terrifying.
What do we have here? Two little brats. Oh, Sacky, it may be time for a snacky. Let's see, naughty or nice.
Get away from them.
If they are truly good, then they should have nothing to hide. Huh, I sense a lot of rebellion in you two. But there are no signs of ill intent. How can that be?
I mean, if you met our parents, you'd understand.
Damn it! You two are not naughty at all. I am eternally bound to never lay a hand on nice people. No matter, there are a multitude of naughty children out there, and I am now let loose since our holly jolly friend is out of commission. Fair up, she done.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean for this to happen.
It's all right, Dave. They manipulated you. It's not your fault. We live and learn.
But what if we don't live and we don't get out?
Let's not be hasty, Dave. We are still alive after all.
How could the ones who say they want to save Christmas be the ones who are destroying it?
Yeah, never trust a wolf in sheep's clothing, son.
Son, you're my father.
It's just a figure of speech.
I guess Christmas really is ruined, and I suppose I won't be getting Papa Porgy's Play Palace in Periwinkle.
Dave, I hate to be the one to tell you this, but you are a grown man. Santa only delivers presents to kids. You aren't getting anything from me.
I know.
If you know, then why do you keep sending letters every year?
I know I am a grown man, and have a family of my own now. But I don't feel like a grown-up. I never have.
You don't feel like a grown-up? What a shocking discovery.
I still like toys, I still love games, and I still love watching baby shows. And most of all, I still love getting presents from Santa Claus on Christmas. Even though I know that time has passed, writing a letter to you every year brings me comfort. Growing up is scary. I don't want to let childish things go. I guess that's why they call me the Childish Dad.
I see, son. But you know that's actually a very admirable trait, still seeing things through the heart of a child, well into your adult years. That is why I do what I do. Spread comfort and joy on one special day of the year just makes this dark world a little more bright. That is what the holidays are about, to make the whole world come together.
And celebrate our differences.
Shut up, you two. Who said you could talk?
Greetings, insignificant mortals. It is I, Angel. I have arrived.
I am Tilly, by the way, Santa Claus Navigator.
I'm Brian, and this is my little sister Emma.
Brian and Emma, You wouldn't happen to be the Childish Dad's kids.
We are, but how do you know our dad?
Believe me, stories of your dad are legendary. They transcend all culture and time.
That's actually why we were out here, looking for dad.
Oh, this isn't a he went to get milk situation, is it?
No way. Our dad doesn't think that sophisticatedly. I guess I should explain.
So your dad was running around with a bunch of nutcases, and you think they are the ones who shot the sleigh down?
Yeah, we tracked his phone here, and they seem to be likely suspects.
So sad. So should we keep tracking Dad's phone and see if Santa is with him?
Even if we do that, the sleigh is still in shambles, and the reindeer run amok. And not to mention how all the presents are destroyed, so if we find SC, it still won't do us any good.
So now what? What are we supposed to do?
I'm not sure.
O mighty angel, we fall at thy feet.
How dare you bow to anyone other than God?
My apologies, angel.
So you claim to be agents of the Lord, and yet you know not the sacred rules, also don't apologize. Only he can forgive.
Angel, you look far different than I thought you'd look.
You dare question my appearance, mortal.
I am.
Do not look me in the eye. Now get on your knees and pray for forgiveness, bitch.
Now where is...
Now where is the sinner Santa Claus?
It looks like you kids need some help over here.
Oh, I said SC again. I was talking about...
I know, you meant Santa Claus. But if I were you, I wouldn't turn down free help. Not to sugarcoat it, but you are in quite the conundrum that nothing short of a miracle can't fix.
What should we do then?
Well, first things first, you should probably find Santa. But, like the elf said, what good would it do if the sleigh is destroyed?
How are we supposed to fix it? It would take 100 people.
Yes, if only there was someone who can fix all this. Someone with a deep connection to the holidays, and who can work miracles. Okay, here's the plan. You kids find Santa, and you help him as best you can. As for me, I'm gonna go get some help. See you at the finale.
Well done, my flock. You have made the Lord proud this day. I wish to speak with the perpetrator alone. Wait outside. Santa Claus, prepare to face the full wrath of the Almighty.
Hello, Krampus.
How'd you know it was me?
Because you're so predictable.
I guess nothing gets past you, Nicholas. Except, I totally got the jump on you with those missiles.
I suppose you did.
Also, you admit I am the superior holiday spirit. I never thought I'd see this day. I could almost cry.
He's scary. I don't like him.
That's strange. Your little girl thought I was funny.
Emma. She is here.
Yes, and your boy too. I wanted to kidnap them, but they are not naughty at all, which is surprising considering the reputation of their father. Now, if you would excuse me, I have much to prepare for. The naughty children of the world aren't going to kidnap themselves.
So, how are we going to find Santa?
I was tracking my dad's phone.
Good idea. If he is still with the suspects, then that will be a good place to start. Well, follow the leader.
Oh, yes, of course.
Huh, is this the bad guy's hideout?
It seems to match the signal on the map.
What should we do next?
I think we should.
Brian, Emma.
Mom, what are you doing here? And how did you find us?
I found your letter and then tracked your phones. You know I have a tracker for each of you.
Hey, wait a minute.
Touché, big brother.
Hey, you two, I am sorry for the way I was acting. I missed not doing Christmas activities with your father, and I have no other excuses.
It's okay, Mom, we understand.
Yeah, being the kids of the Childish Dad, we know better than anyone that adults deal with problems too.
So, who's your new friend?
My name is Tilly, one of Santa's elves. Pleased to meet you, Mrs. Johnson.
Wait, you're one of what?
Now my simps, I mean flock. I want you to keep an eye on those two for the time being.
Wait, you're not going to punish Santa?
You dare question me again. I am so disappointed in you all. I shall have to tell the big man himself about this.
No, please. Forgive us.
We are sorry, Angel.
please spare us.
Oh, you want forgiveness? Then get on your knees and repent. You wretched sinners unworthy of God's love.
Let's be real. If you had an opportunity to do something like this, you'd do it too.
Hold on, they shot the sleigh down?
They sure did, with missiles and everything.
This is a lot to take in.
Yeah, these episodes are becoming bloated.
Look, everyone, I think we have an opening.
We are at your mercy.
We are not worthy.
I am so ashamed.
Okay, leader, what's the plan?
Okay. Emma, Mom, you wait here. Tilly, you're with me.
Hello.
Brian.
Tilly.
OMG, we're saved.
Shush. They are still outside. We need a way to get rid of them. I got it. Gonna need your elf skills.
I feel so guilty.
So humiliated.
We need a cleanser from that cleansing.
Yeah, let's rough up the prisoners.
But Angel said...
Yeah, about Santa, but he said nothing about Dave.
Don't you dare touch him.
Quite you, he who turned a holy holiday into a consumerism hellhole. No one can save you now.
Come on, soldiers. Let's break Dave's kneecaps.
We interrupt this Christmas Eve to bring you some breaking news. Tonight, Congress has passed a bill to outlaw capitalism. America is now a communist nation.
Good job, Brian. But I am a bit confused. They were just complaining about Christmas becoming too consumerism-driven, and yet get upset when capitalism ends.
Welcome to American politics.
Sure feels good to get out.
Dad!
Oh, Dave, are you okay?
Well, Catherine, it was scary. They were going to break my knees.
Well, you're safe now. That's what matters.
But what about Santa's sleigh? Without it, Christmas can't proceed.
So about that. Apparently a new friend is trying to find someone to fix it.
Who could possibly fix the sleigh before the end of Christmas Eve?
He didn't say, but he seemed assured enough.
Thought you could fool us, could you?
I mean, I think we did.
Shut up. We don't like being humiliated or mocked for what we believe in.
That's rich coming from people who force their beliefs on others.
Kids, I think it's best we don't antagonize them.
Yeah, that's right, fat boy. You know when you are defeated.
I would say I admit defeat, but I never lie.
Oh, what's that pussy whistle supposed to...
Stupid reindeer.
Okay. Are you all prepared to defend Christmas from the fiends and show them what they get when they try and destroy it?
I'm more than ready.
Count me up.
Me as well.
You need not say more.
Then on me. Attack.
Are you kidding me right now? How about a little help?
Had enough?
Never. As long as the war on Christmas wages on, I will never have enough.
War on Christmas? Wait a minute, those initials are W, O, and C. So you're woke?
Yes, I mean no. You tricked me.
Giddy up.
It's very rude to sneak up on people. I listen to them fighting. It doesn't matter. Even if Nick is free, it changes nothing. Even him being temporarily out of whack, no one can stop me now. You see, we holiday spirits have immunity. We are forbidden to fight one another, so Santa Claus cannot stop me.
A blue-haired demon, kill it!
It's teal, not blue. So I managed to find help, and I think you all know him.
It is I, and I bring you great tidings of great joy.
Our the begotten son has come, just in time to watch it all revert back to me.
My lord, I can't believe it's you!
Hello Franklin, Jacob, Theodore and Janice.
He knows our names.
Now that you're here, lord, you can help us save your holiest of holidays, and the perpetrator Santa Claus is right there.
So he is. Well then, I'd best give him the greeting he so properly deserves. Nicholas.
Jesus.
How have you been, Nicholas?
Doing well, old friend.
Friend!
And how is Mrs. Claus?
She's doing very well. Thank you for asking.
You two know each other?
Of course. Nicholas and I go way back.
But he is the one tainting the holiday.
Tainting the holiday? I am afraid I know not what you mean.
But he comes from a pagan tradition.
So did the three wise men who brought gifts at my birth. What of it?
But what about the war on Christmas?
Oh, dear child, that is just a modern construct used to divide people. I never said anything about a war on Christmas. A lot of holiday traditions predate my birth, and I have no problem with people celebrating them in their own ways.
But this cannot be!
How could you stand for such blasphemous things?
Why are they still acting like this, even though he's right in front of them?
I guess the power of God is still no match for the Pope.
Sacrilege!
Impiety!
Profanity!
Heresy!
Hypocrisy! I have had countless followers in the past 2,000 years, and it is disappointing to see that most of them don't live the way I did at all.
Wah, what do you mean?
All of the frauds. All of the hypocrites. Those who take the comfort, joy, love, and above all else, nuance of my words, and warp them into reasons to inflict violence, and force their own ideologies onto others. Those all I can unto you, preach my word, and use my name, but you don't live like unto me, which makes my heart grieve. But I forgive you, because that is what I do. No one is above reproach.
Thank you, I guess.
I wouldn't consider yourselves lucky just yet, because even if it is his job to show mercy, there are still a lot of folks out here who you crossed! Sorry, sir. Anyway... I'm not so sure they will be very quick to forgive.
Peace be with you. Now then, let us undo what was undone.
Thank you.
must bestow unto you my most sincere reaction of surprise. You have all played your parts well in dismantling all of my sinister plans. But it all matters not whether Santa flies tonight. I will continue to spread my malice and fear on this Yuletide, and no one will stop me.
Santa, you have to stop him.
He can't.
I am sorry, Brian, but we holiday spirits are forbidden to fight one another. My hands are tied.
Mr. Jesus, can you fight him?
I am afraid not, Emma dear. I too am a holiday spirit.
Hey, what about you? You can fight him.
I'm not so sure about that.
What do you mean?
Look, even if I could beat him, I too am bound by a pact. If I alter the course of the Vion world too much, I'll be violating that. And I already interfered here way too much.
Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. Looks like no one can step up to the plate and champion your meager holiday. Krampus won, the rest of you zero. Now the hour grows late, and I have much to do. Fair option. Who dares challenge the great Krampus?
Dave.
I have been called. I have been called to a special calling, for this is my favorite holiday, and these evil forces that wish to tear it down and punish those who stand for it shall not prevail.
Is that so, little man?
I, David William Jonathan Johnson, colloquially known as the Childish Dad.
I am surprised you know what colloquial means.
To save Christmas.
Kick his ass, Dad.
Why?
Bring the snowball to a boulder fight will die accordingly. Come now, you won't feel a thing. Here I come. Oh! Hey, that hurt.
Fire.
Bombard.
Hold the line, troops.
Advance. We will win this day.
It's getting serious out there.
I should go help.
Just wait. Your father seems to have it under control.
V9.
What are you talking about? I am the least benign being on the planet.
I meant benign on the board.
I know. You just sent another one. How do you keep doing that? Are you cheating?
I just went with a strategy.
Very well. You leave me no choice but to pull out the big guns. F-U.
But those are both letters.
Good thing I have leftover missiles.
Dad!
Emma, no.
Dave.
I win. If there was any doubt, only a slow-witted fool could think about challenging the mighty Krampus. Thinking you had a chance against me is so childish. I think I may have found my first victim of the night.
No. Dad.
What could be a better fate for the grown man with the mind of a toddler than to be treated like the big brat that you are? Osaki. It's time for a snacky.
Thank you.
Saki. But, how?
Oh, Krampus, have you forgotten your most important rule? You are never to lay a hand on good people.
But you don't mean...
Rules are rules.
No, this cannot be. You cheat.
We all have principles to follow, Krampus, and these are yours.
This isn't fair. This was supposed to be my year.
Did I say Christmas?
I think you did, Dave. I think you did.
Dad!
Oh no, I am naked. Much better.
And that will be the last miracle of the night. It was an honor to lend my hand here tonight, and to see all these new and old faces. Now the time has come for me to return to the heavens. Christmas blessings to you all.
I should be heading out too. I need to join my friends and family for Christmas, and I don't want to miss that. Happy holidays, everyone.
Come, Tilly. We should be setting off.
Be right there, boss. See you later, Emma. It was nice meeting you.
Bye, Tilly.
So long, Brian. Thank you for taking charge out there today. You are a natural leader.
Thank you, Tilly. You did good yourself.
You know, I think I should come visit you sometime.
Really? You do that?
Yeah, I would love for you to meet my boyfriend, Mingo. I think you two would get along well.
Boyfriend.
Goodbye, Brian. Until then.
Later.
Sorry about that, big bro.
Sorry. Sorry about what?
Love hurts, doesn't it?
You don't know what you're talking about.
Do you hear that? Oh, he's crying.
Serves him right.
Yeah. Let's go cheer him up.
Emma, no.
Hey, Mr. Krampus. Oops, I forgot.
Yeah, kick me while I'm down. Next, you might as well take a sock full of nickels to my crouch, for good measure.
I don't see a problem with that.
Brian.
It's not fair. I am a holiday spirit, just like Santa and Jesus. All I ever wanted to do is to kidnap naughty children.
Because not kidnapping children is certainly worth sobbing over.
Well, excuse me for being a little peeved for losing the one thing I know. What am I to do now?
Well, Mr. Krampus, have you considered celebrating your holiday another way?
I don't know. I have been doing this for so long. It's really hard to truly change.
Not that my advice matters, but have you considered kidnapping anyone other than kids?
What are you talking about?
Kids are the future, Krampus. Them acting out against authority can be a good thing. It hardly seems fair to punish them for that. But what about evil adults? Wouldn't the world be a better place without them?
Evil adults, you say? I mean, it could be worth a try, in fact. It may just be a good idea. Now I see why I couldn't kidnap you earlier. You have a rebellious spirit, which means you want to fight for a better world. From this Yule night and onward, Krampus will steal away naughty grown-ups. And I think I know where to start.
Ah, screw them! Screw them all!
What? They all think they are better than us.
And what about that Jesus guy? Who does he think he is?
Yeah, the way he said that we don't live like him, what does he know?
So the war on Christmas wages on. This year was very disappointing. Back to the grind, because next year will be different.
Oh, next year will indeed be different. But probably not in the way you think.
Who are you, demon?
Demon? Oh, come now, you don't...
Recognize an angel when you see one.
Angel?
Yes, your angel of demise. I am Krampus, and I am here to punish you for your transgressions.
But, we are servants of the Lord, we have no transgressions.
Oh, is that so? Then we'll just see about that. Osaki! It is finally time for a snacky.
Well, I've always wanted to be a martyr.
Dad, it's just you and me left. What are we going to do?
Nothing to do but to outrun. Outrun it. And outrun you.
Bastard.
Oh, I'm beat. But I should be safe. The blob can't climb. You have got to be kidding me. You've eaten 3 people. How hungry are you? Yeah, that's right. Slink away. What? No. Leave me alone. No, I can't hold on.
Little Saki Wacky, a good night's meal. And there is more where that came from. So where should we go next? Oh, what was that? The Supreme Court. Oh, you don't even need to ask twice. I love you so much.
Dave. You were great back there. Sometimes I forget how much you surprise me. Who would have thought that all your panic about Christmas being destroyed would result in you actually saving the holiday? Well, it is your favorite time of year, after all.
Yeah, it is my favorite time of year. But I learned a lot today. I've done some real maturing. Catherine, I knew all along that Santa wasn't going to bring me Papa Porgy's Play Palace in Periwinkle. And, yesterday, if I saw there was no present for me under the tree, Christmas morning, I think I would have been very upset. But, I don't mind anymore. I know I am not getting a gift from Santa, and I am okay with that. I am a grown up, and that's okay.
That's very mature of you, Dave, but don't lose yourself too much.
What do you mean?
Your kind and childish heart, though it can bring out the worst in you sometimes, it also brings out the best. Come on, let's go home.
Catherine. Catherine, wake up.
Good morning, dear, and Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Catherine. Merry Christmas, Emma.
Merry Christmas. You're not going to crash into me.
Not today. Good morning, Brian. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Brian.
Did it happen again?
Nope, not today.
Then Merry Christmas, Emma. Come on.
I think this one is yours, Brian.
Oh, thank you, sis.
Oh, look. Santa got me my quad skates. What about you, Brian?
New audio equipment. Just what I asked for.
Wow, so cool.
Hey dear, is everything okay?
Yeah, I'm great.
You know, it's okay to be disappointed. I hope you know that.
I'm not disappointed. You know why? Just like you said, I am happy to see the kids. Seeing them opening the gifts really does bring back special memories. Honestly, those memories are enough for me.
You're really serious, aren't you?
Of course, I don't need a present from Santa to be happy. Being with my family is enough.
Hey, what's this present? It was hidden in the back.
Dad, it has your name on it.
It does.
It sure does.
And there's a note too. Read it, Dad.
Dear Dave,
I hope you are having a wonderful Christmas with Catherine and the kids. I just wanted to thank you for your help last night and for keeping me company in the cell. And the best way I know how to say thank you is through a present. Now remember this. This will be the last gift you ever receive from me. So cherish it, son. Have a wonderful holiday.
Love, Santa Claus.
Well, how about that? Seems like he brought you one after all.
Yes, I suppose he did. Well, I guess there is only one thing left to do. Have a wonderful holiday season, everyone.
So we need a little music, need a little laughter, need a little singing, ringing through the rafter, and we need after.
I'm sorry. I can't wait any longer. Wow. It's Papa Porgy's Play Palace.
Need a little Christmas love.
Oh no. This is Papa Porgy's Play Palace in Parmesan. I wanted Papa Porgy's Play Palace in Periwinkle.
Dave.
Oh no.
Why?